Number three says, my father is Irish and my mother is English. Okay, so let's find out what our verbs are. Is,
right.
Oh, but wait, there's two is's. Well, that's because there could be two verbs, right? Okay. And then on this one, who is?
Father is,
right? And what about on this one?
Mother is,
right? And what is my father? He is Irish. So that is a predicate adjective describing who he is. What about mother? Mother is English. That's a predicate adjective describing that she is English, right? And then we have my mother and my father. So remember, these are adjectives, right? Okay. And then we have and. What is and? It's our conjunction. You're right. Ooh, now this has a comma and this is right in the middle. Now, when I look at this, I have a subject and a verb, and then I also have another subject and verb. So what is that going to mean for diagramming? Okay, that means that I'm going to have one complete sentence, right? And then I'm going to have another complete sentence when I have this type of conjunction with a subject and verb on one side and the subject and verb on the other side. So on my top one, let's go ahead and do that one. We have father, I apologize, wrong side, right? We have father is, and then what is Irish? So we have to do our diagonal line, and we have Irish, and then we have and, right? And then we have mother, and we have is, and then we have our other diagonal line, and she is English for our predicate adjective. And then we also have our regular adjectives of my and my off father and mother, okay? So remember that when you have two, a verb and a subject and a verb and a subject, we're going to do this because it's like having two complete sentences, then they join together in the middle with that, okay? Number four says, the study of Spanish is quite interesting. Okay, well, let's go ahead and find out. What is our verb here?
Is.
Okay, and what is? What is?
Study, right.
Okay, but then what makes of Spanish? Because it's not, we're not is Spanish, it's is study. Well, that makes of Spanish our prepositional phrase, because remember, of is a preposition word. Okay, now the study, study is, what is it? It is interesting. Here we go. Predicate adjective again, right? Because that is describing that it is interesting, that the study is interesting, right? Okay, and then what would quite be? Quite would then be describing, right? Interesting, meaning this would be, it's also adjective, okay? Now let's diagram this one. Don't forget, we have to diagram this prepositional phrase. So we start off with is. What is study? Oh, I forgot the, right? The study, that's our adjective, A-D-J, right? Showing our adjective. Okay, we have study is. Then we have our predicate adjective with our diagonal line of interesting. Okay, and then we have of Spanish, that is modifying study. So we have to come over here and do our diagonal of for preposition word and then Spanish, right? Okay, and then we also have quite, right? That's our adjective here, Q-U-I-T-E. Okay, so here we have our verb, our subject, our adjective, then we have our preposition, and then we have our diagonal showing our predicate adjective, and then our another adjective describing that. Number five says, Blake is absent today. Okay, so what is our verb? Is, and what is Blake, our subject, and Blake is what? He's absent, right? So he, and so this is predicate, adjective, describing what he is, he's absent, and when is he absent? He is absent today, right? So today is actually describing is on when he is, answering the question when, okay? So now let's go ahead and diagram this one. Okay, diagramming this, we would go ahead and do our T. We have is on the right, Blake on the left, and then we have our predicate adjective, right, which is absent, okay, with our diagonal line. And then we have when is he absent is, when is he absent? That would be today, so we are describing the time of when, and we have that coming off of is. Okay, so this is number 5. Fifth grade, it is now time for you guys to do think, see on your own. So you're going to either do that on the back side of the diagram page I gave you, or if I gave you 2 pages, then do that on the second page indicating at the top that it's page 87. You should have that on the top no matter what for this. Okay, so that means you're going to do 1 through 10 on your own. So yes, you're going to first start off by doing this, underlining the subject once and the verb 2 times. Put parentheses around any prepositional phrases, and then you're going to diagram either your predicate adjective this way, or predicate nominative, or your direct object, and if there is an indirect object. So you're gonna diagram every single word. You guys know how to do this. You know how to diagram your subject, verb, your adjectives. You know how to diagram your prepositional phrases. If you need to look back at the preposition words, please do that just to give you a recap. And then now you're doing the predicate adjective or nominative and the direct object and indirect object. So go ahead and complete that. Now, if you come across something where you don't understand, make a note, and then when we talk, we can go over that, okay? That's what those times that I'm calling you about are, individual times, is that you make a note or circle something, and then we can go over that. That way you're understanding it. Don't just say, I got it, and figure it out, because once you turn it in, you might not got it, and then it might cause you problems in the future with other assignments. This is virtual teaching. Yes, you are watching a video, but you also can reach me at all day long, anytime during the day, so you can ask these questions, okay? So reach out if you need it, and go ahead and complete Think See on your own. And I know you guys are capable of doing it. You guys do diagramming really well. And if you need help, reach out. Enjoy your day on language.